Hello, everyone. Glory to God. And we are in a series titled Win the Day. And our main text is found in the book of Proverbs 27 and verse 1, where it says, don't look at tomorrow. You need to deal with today. And in dealing with the day, if you're going to have a successful day, remember decisions, actions, words, your words, and now. Focus on the now. Your decisions are vital. Your actions are vital. Your words are so important. And be in the now. Focus on today. And that's what Proverbs 27 lets us know. So those four letters, okay, that the Lord had given me spell Don, decisions, actions, words, now. So important in having a successful day. Our example we're finding right here in Scripture, a young lady by the name of Rahab. So we're going to pick it up in the book of Joshua in the second chapter. Let me set this up for you. Joshua has sent two men in to spy out Jericho. Rahab let these two spies into her house, and it's important to understand that Rahab lived in Jericho. She was a Jericho citizen. Okay, and the children of Israel was their enemy, and the children of Israel, of course, were coming in there to take over. And so Rahab made the decision, took the action of hiding the spies, protecting the spies, had them up on the roof, covered them up with leaves and straws and everything. And one of the elders there in Jericho came, hey, did you see the spies? You know, these guys are up to no good. And they took off and they went looking for them the whole time. The actions of Rahab was she hid the spies. She made the right decision. She took the right action. And now we're going to show you some of the words that Rahab spoke. Second chapter of Joshua, beginning with verse 8, it says, and before they were laid down, she came up unto them upon the roof. So the spies, they're upstairs on the roof. Again, Joshua sent them in, and they're on the roof of Rahab's house. So she goes up to them. Verse 9, and she said unto the two spies that Joshua sent in, I know that the Lord has given you the land, and that your terror is fallen upon us, and that all the inhabitants of our land, they faint because of you. She's saying, hey, we're scared in Jericho. Okay, we know that God is with you guys. Rahab continues. She says, and again, the importance of words, okay, and win the day. For we have heard how the Lord dried up the water of the Red Sea for you when you came out of Egypt, and what you did unto the two kings of the Amorites. And then she continues in verse 11, she says, and as soon as we heard these things, our hearts did melt. Neither did there remain any more courage in any man because of you. For the Lord your God, he is God in heaven above and in earth beneath. So Rahab is speaking encouraging, powerful, awesome, truthful words. She lets the two spies know that the city is scared. The people heard about the Red Sea. I mean, I would be scared too if I heard about, man, the water stood up and these children of Israel marched right through it. And then Pharaoh's army got blown up as the waters came back. So the folks in Jericho, they're terrified. They're saying, only God could do that. Okay, and so Rahab is speaking the words. So let's take a look at her day. One, she made the right decision by hiding the spies. Two, the action, cover them up so that they couldn't be found. Three, she's speaking the words. She's explaining, letting them know that the people of Jericho are petrified and in. She's doing it now. Okay? She's not waiting till tomorrow or the next day. She is dealing with this right now. And so it continues. And I think I'm going to pick this up next week. And I want you all to know that when you win the day, it can have long-term blessings. And that's what we're going to show you tomorrow. The phenomenal blessings that Rahab enjoyed for her and her entire family because she made the right decision, she took the proper actions, she spoke the right words, and she did it today, which is now. Be encouraged, follow this formula, and I know that it will bring the same blessings that it brought Rahab. God bless you. We'll see you next time.